Welcome to a special edition of Microsoft Mechanics, where we're joined by Azure CVP Julia White to look at how you can enable seamless management across your hybrid and multi-cloud environments and tap into Azure services locally by taking advantage of the latest updates to Azure Arc and the newly refactored Azure Stack HCI. Julia, thanks for joining us from your home in Seattle and welcome back to Microsoft Mechanics.
It is great to be back.
So it's an interesting moment in time that we find ourselves in today where both users and IT are often working remotely. For IT teams, that brings about additional challenges. They need to deal with higher and varying user demand for services as more people work away from the office, in addition to the increased complexities of operating and managing an often diverse IT estate spanning their own data centers and across multiple clouds.
And yeah, it really is unprecedented. And in response, we're seeing a lot of organizations accelerating their cloud use to meet these demands, like quickly scaling up and down, simplified management, and higher levels of security.
But as they do that, hybrid continues to be the common approach, but increasingly managing multi-cloud environments as well.
Right. Now, Azure has always been hybrid by design. And starting about a year ago, we took that hybrid expertise and extended it to enabling multi-cloud and multi-edge capabilities as well. So now, as you look at Azure hybrid capabilities holistically, we give you that seamless approach to running and managing your applications across on-prem, multi-cloud, and at the edge. Specifically, now with Azure Arc, you have a consistent control plane for all of your resources wherever they reside. With Azure Arc-enabled services, you can deploy Azure fully managed services anywhere, on-prem and in other clouds. For example, Azure SQL Managed Database can literally be run anywhere. And with Azure Stack Portfolio, you can bring Azure consistent infrastructure directly into your data centers and even run it on existing certified hardware with Azure Stack HCI. And we also know that increasingly new applications being built include running some aspects at the edge. So we've brought in our comprehensive Azure IoT portfolio, such that there's consistency in the, for the developer, as well as the management and security experience, all the way to the gateway or those tiny MCU devices like Azure Sphere.
Awesome. So this takes hybrid to the next level, and you can take advantage of Azure on your terms and truly innovate anywhere. Now, Azure Arc was the big announcement last Ignite. And before we get into the updates, can you give us some examples of what you can do with Azure Arc from a management perspective?
Yeah, so Azure Arc really is that single control plane. We help you bring all of your servers, VMs, Kubernetes clusters, and containers under central management so that you can take control of your infrastructure sprawl and reduce governance complexity.
And this is what most people are interested in doing today.
Right. And if you're running Kubernetes in your environment, that provides a cloud-native cross-platform infrastructure. And Azure Arc enables you to do two key things. First, the ability to consistently deploy and manage your Kubernetes-based applications anywhere at scale using your favorite DevOps approach. And secondly, we've done the work to Arc enable many of our PaaS services. So you can deploy and manage Azure services like our data services literally anywhere. Customers have been super enthusiastic about this capability because, you know, data often either needs to reside on-prem or needs to be standardized across all environments. With the ability for Azure data services to run anywhere, you have the best of both worlds. You can have that fully managed, always up-to-date database and have complete control of where it's running.
And this brings about, as you say, a lot more consistency and a lot less complexity. So can you show us the tech in action and the latest updates?
Yeah, sure. Let me show you. There's been a ton of momentum. First, at the foundational level, we've shipped Azure Arc enabled servers to provide that seamless management for servers running in any environment. Now, as you can see here, represented by the blue disks, this all brings your Windows or Linux servers under policy management wherever they are. I can ensure that all of my servers have the right policies and configurations applied. I'll click into this dev test server on AWS and view its compliance with my policies. And you'll see a holistic view of compliance. And a few of these policies with the purple icons are even provisioning management extensions or agents. So beyond just monitoring, I can also send configurations like these extensions down to any server I've scoped for policy. And this is also great for Azure managed service partners who are managing multiple customers using Azure Lighthouse along with Azure Arc. Here, I'll click into a customer. You'll see all the resources I've been delegated. I'll choose Tailwind Traders. And now I not only can manage what I need to in Azure, but with Azure Arc, I can manage on-premises or cross-cloud resources like these VMs you see here. So this opens up new possibilities for managed service partners who need to keep highly distributed resources and services running across all of their customers.
And we just showed recently on Microsoft Mechanics how we can bring SQL servers that may be residing on servers in your environment under management with Azure Arc-enabled SQL Server.
Right, this is currently in public preview. If I drill in here, I can see the details about the SQL server, such as the version and edition, which helps me inventory all of my SQL servers, regardless of where they're located. If I click here on environment health, you can now also use our SQL assessment service, which analyzes your SQL server and makes best practice configuration recommendations.
And you mentioned that the big promise of Azure Arc is to deliver Azure services anywhere.
That's right. And we've started with Azure Arc-enabled Kubernetes that's now in public preview. And here you're seeing Azure Arc-enabled Kubernetes. This brings consistent management to all of your Kubernetes clusters, wherever they are. In fact, here we have clusters in 3 on-premises data centers, 1 in AWS, but it could be in any cloud, and 1 on Azure Stack HCI, and 1 more in Azure.
And this is really great momentum on Azure Arc, but as we bring our cloud to the edge, the Azure Stack portfolio has also received quite a few updates.
Right. We're seeing customers increasingly put AI on the edge, running on devices sitting in the physical world to enable several new use cases. We now have a GPU-enabled Azure Stack Edge device, which is perfect for local video inferencing. In fact, RXR Realty are using these capabilities to run our new custom vision and spatial analysis models on data from their security cameras to ensure that social distancing is happening within their buildings. But beyond Azure Stack Edge, we also have a lot of updates to Azure Stack HCI for hyperconverged infrastructure. First, Azure Stack HCI has been completely refactored into a purpose-built OS for virtualization. It includes the latest hypervisor with built-in software-defined storage and networking, and it's designed for scale and performance. We've demonstrated as much as 1 million IOPS per server. It includes built-in disaster recovery with stretch clustering that allows your cluster to be spread across separate geographical locations. You have the flexibility to deploy on hardware from your choice of vendor, either by purchasing a new integrated system with the software pre-installed or reusing suitable existing hardware that you already have. You only pay per core. Your payment is part of your existing Azure subscription, so it really is an extension of your Azure capabilities. And best of all, it's also integrated with Azure Arc for remote monitoring and management.
And one thing to stress here is you only pay per core monthly, which means there's no upfront license cost. And as it's a subscription service, you're always kept up to date. Okay, so we've brought people up to date with Azure Arc and Azure Stack with some major updates to Azure Stack HCI. Let's show everyone how they can start to come together. And I'll start by deploying an Azure Stack HCI cluster. And then Julia, you can show management in Azure Arc and how easy it is to add Azure services.
Great, let's do it.
Now, the first thing I want to show you is just how easy we've made it to deploy an HCI cluster. So what we have on our screen here is one of the nodes running Azure Stack HCI, which I deployed using my regular deployment methods. And I've done a few things ahead of time, such as join the domain, configure a few basic network settings. But where the real magic happens is in Windows Admin Center, specifically in the new cluster creation wizard for Azure Stack HCI, which hugely simplifies the setup process for both local clusters, but also the new stretch clusters, which, as we said, are unique to Azure Stack HCI. So let's kick off the process, and I'm going to show you how easy it is to deploy a local cluster in this case. So we'll go next. Now, I've already added the 2 servers ahead of time and their domain joined in this case. An admin center can automate installing the required features on each node, which is really useful. It's also going to ensure that our systems are up to date. And if needed, it'll also reboot the systems ahead of the next step, which is networking. Firstly, admin center is going to detect our network cards. Then it's going to ask us to dedicate 1 or 2 NICs for management. So we'll make a selection on each node. And then we'll apply and test those changes and wait a moment. And all good. Next, we'll configure the rest of our network adapters with names, addresses, subnet masks, and VLAN IDs, and then we'll apply and test those changes. And as you can see, that's all working great. We'll finally define a vSwitch, which will allow our VMs to communicate out on those hosts. So we'll make a selection, we'll apply and test, wait a few moments, and all good. Well, then at this point, we can validate the cluster configuration to ensure that we have an optimal setup and we catch any errors or misconfigurations before the cluster is created. And that itself just takes a few moments, and once validated, we can view the validation report and then move on to create the cluster. We'll provide a name, and under advanced, I'm going to specify a static IP address for communication and ongoing management. And we can then create the cluster, which again takes just a few moments. And behind the scenes, Admin Center is orchestrating the whole setup, which makes things really easy. And once created, we can finalize the storage by first cleaning the drives in each of our nodes. We'll verify everything, validate the storage to ensure it's ready for our software-defined storage technology, Storage Spaces Direct. And once complete, we'll enable that to complete the process, turning on the relevant health providers, services, and configuring the cluster to support Storage Spaces Direct. And that's it, cluster created. And from here, all you need to do is quickly register this, and it should show up in your Azure portal.
Awesome. That was actually straightforward. Let's have a look at the experience within the Azure portal. So I'll open up the Azure Stack HCI blade in the portal, and I can see our Azure Stack HCI cluster here that is now Azure Arc enabled for management. And I can see it's connected and information about the two nodes in our cluster.
And the good news is here, so we're working on bringing centralized health monitoring, alerting, and update management to this experience soon too, which is awesome.
Yeah, so now you have a way to host your VMs on Azure Stack HCI, but to light up more Azure Arc capabilities, let's deploy Kubernetes. We've just announced the preview of Azure Kubernetes Service on Azure Stack HCI, which automates the deployment of the Kubernetes infrastructure. This opens up opportunities to do several things, such as container-based way of scaling elastically on demand. And by the way, this is one of the mechanisms we use at Microsoft to respond to increased service demand around COVID. Now, also, as I mentioned, adding Kubernetes allows you to deploy Azure services, such as Azure Arc-enabled data services, directly onto Azure Stack HCI.
Right, and deploying Kubernetes on-premises in the past hasn't always been the easiest process. So let me also show you how simple it is to deploy AKS on HCI so that you can take advantage of it. So I'm going to go back to the Windows Admin Center to start this two-part process. And on the screen, we have the Azure Stack HCI cluster we've deployed previously. And in the bottom left here, you can see an Admin Center extension for the Azure Kubernetes service. Now, remember, this is in preview, so it's subject to change. But for this first part of this process, we're going to deploy our Kubernetes management infrastructure onto this HCI cluster. So we'll review the prereqs, and then we'll move on to check our HCI cluster. It's going to validate my creds, then review the admin center and HCI cluster settings. And as you can see, it'll make a couple of changes, including adding any necessary firewall changes, roles and features, any other adjustments. Next is the host configuration, where we'll name our management cluster, choose where we'll store our VMs for this cluster, and define a few of the network settings, including a load balancer if required. We'll provide some Azure connectivity info, and I'm going to choose to send diagnostic info to improve the product so that we can enhance it as we go forward. Then we'll review and create, and that's going to go ahead and download all the necessary components and deploy our management infrastructure onto our HCI cluster. Now that's going to take a few minutes, and so cooking show style, I'll go to one I completed earlier. So with that process completed, we can now start this second wizard, which will deploy the actual Kubernetes cluster that will ultimately run our workloads. Now what's nice about this wizard is the series of steps matches those steps for deploying AKS clusters in Azure, so great usability consistency there. So we'll provide the basic info, we're going to integrate with Azure Arc by providing a subscription and a resource group. Then we'll provide info about our target HCI environment, along with credentials and some VM sizing info for the primary node pool, which runs some key system services. We'll then define some worker node pools, which will run our apps. And I'm creating two pools, one for Linux and one for Windows, each with two nodes. And I can define the sizes of those VMs too. I can configure some network settings, including load balancing, define persistent storage for our environment. And finally, I review my settings and click Create. And within a few minutes, we'll have our Kubernetes cluster created and integrated with Azure Arc. So you should see it then in your Azure portal alongside your other Kubernetes clusters.
Great. And this really abstracts a lot of that complexity and makes it easy to deploy Kubernetes on-prem on top of Azure Stack HCI. So with those pieces in place, we're ready to deploy Azure Arc-enabled data services. Data services provide self-service provisioning of Azure SQL and Postgres Hyperscale, and will then manage those database instances with built-in monitoring, backup, restore, HA, and more. Now, as I mentioned before, you're still in your local data center, and your apps can still connect like they always have, but you have a fully managed data services platform. So let's go through the Azure portal experience of deploying Azure Arc-enabled data services from the marketplace. Starting here in the marketplace, I'll click on Create for an Azure Arc Data Controller. I'll read up here on the prerequisites and click Data Controller Details. And here I'll provide the Azure subscription, resource group, and the Azure location as usual. Then I'll provide a name for the data controller and select AKS deployment profile and click Open into Azure Data Studio. Here you can see that the Azure portal has automatically created a notebook which I can download and run in Azure Data Studio. From here, I can click Run All at the top and kick off the notebook, which will deploy an Azure Arc data controller to my Kubernetes cluster. Once we've deployed Azure data services, there are a variety of ways to deploy Azure SQL or Postgres Hyperscale servers. Anybody with the right permissions can deploy a database instance from Azure Data Studio in seconds using this wizard. And as new features are added to Azure SQL, I'll get the latest features and updates automatically and right away. My application developers won't need to wait for the DBA team to upgrade to the next version of SQL Server to get all the latest and greatest.
And while we showed how Azure Arc enabled data services can run on any infrastructure on any Kubernetes environment before, this is a bit different.
Right. What's different now versus what you might have seen before is that we're running on an end-to-end stack that is fully provided and supported by Microsoft. The virtualization layer is Azure Stack HCI, and all the Kubernetes nodes, which can be Windows or Linux VMs, are supported by Microsoft. So we give you the complete stack, including the data services and the other Azure Arc-enabled services that you can run on certified hardware in your data center.
And we've really just scratched the surface here on what's possible across multi-cloud and multi-edge scenarios. But where can people go and learn more?
Well, you can always go to azure.com to learn more about Azure Stack and Azure Arc and get access to the latest previews of everything. And we've also got lots of hands-on tutorials so you can kind of fast-track your learning path. So you can check those out as well.
Awesome. Thanks again, Julia, for joining us today. That's all we have time for today, and we hope we managed to answer your questions on the topic. Tell us what you think, hit subscribe if you haven't already, and keep watching Microsoft Mechanics for the latest tech updates. Bye for now.